The following is an excerpt from Wildflowers and Wooden Spoons, and is about the many lessons I learned when I learned how to make Grandpa's gnocchi. When I was 10 years old, I asked permission to make gnocchi for my family on a Sunday. I told my mother I wanted to make gnocchi like Grandma and Grandpa. So one Sunday, directly after church, I set about in the kitchen with the task of making enough hand-rolled gnocchi for my family of seven. This process took hours, and finally, every bit of gnocchi dough was rolled out and placed on floured surfaces all over the kitchen. I put the pot of water on the stove, brought it to a boil, and slowly added all the gnocchi I had so tenderly rolled with my two small hands. I was thrilled to have accomplished such a task. What a triumph! Then, as I began to stir the pot of gnocchi, I noticed to my horror that all the gnocchi I had added to the boiling water had stuck together in one large gnocchi ball. I remember my younger brother laughing and my mother getting out a box of spaghetti. I had failed. The proud story I had planned to share with Grandpa was ruined. It would take years for me to learn that failure is an important part of success. I eventually learned how to make gnocchi successfully, and to this day, I'm the only member of my family who still makes gnocchi the way Grandma and Grandpa did. I have learned much from kitchen failures, and now value them as important learning experiences. When I owned my little cafe, a customer once said, "Everything you make is so perfect." I thanked her, but said, "Not everything I make is perfect. I just don't serve you, my failures." Wildflowers and Wooden Spoons, a cookbook with stories and recipes from childhood and cafe days, will be released in November of 2021. You can order it at pattylucciawrites.com.